Welcome everybody to this presentation on trend monitoring. I would like to show you how to do it yourself with the EPO's tools as BuzzNet, GPI and Padstat. The talk is subdivided in two parts. In the first, I will show you how to analyze technological trends using a case study that we have recently published. It is about secure communication with quantum key distribution. In the second part, I will show you how to discover unknown trends by analyzing CPC co-assignments. So first, I would like to refer to the Patent Insight report that just has been published in November 2021. It is a cooperation of the EPO with the European Space Policy Institute, ESPI, and the European Space Agency, ESA. The objectives of the studies are to stimulate innovation in Europe in the area of quantum technologies for space. And we identified three relevant areas: quantum key distribution, cold atom clock, and cold atom interferometers. Quantum key distribution is on secure communication. Cold atom clocks is about ultra-precise measurement of time. And cold atom interferometers is on Earth sensing. So measuring the gravitational field of the Earth, for example. We want to use this case to show the effective use of patent information. And I will dive now into the queries that we have done. And doing so, I will show you how to actually implement some of the queries that we have done there in SBuzzNet. First of all, let's understand what this technology is about. It's about secure communication using encryption keys. And quantum mechanics actually allows you to exchange those encryption keys in a secure way, making sure that nobody can listen to you. Because if somebody listens to your signals, it will change the signals, it will change the entangled photons that are exchanged between the receiver and the sender, and you will realize that. And this way you can make sure that if somebody listens to you, that you will know and you will not use this key and you will do another key exchange. We involved examiners developing the keywords, and they advised also to use some protocols. So there are some specific protocols in this domain that help us to find relevant innovations and inventions. If we do these searches with the keywords alone, we find a lot of documents. We find 500,000 documents with these keywords, where the searches are not very precise. What we can do to improve it, we can add some classification symbols. The classification symbols are assigned by the examiners, and they make sure that these keywords are not simply mentioned in some other inventions just in the periphery, but that the inventions themselves are about improving these technologies. So we have the classification symbol H04L9, which is on arrangements for secret and secure communication and cryptography. And there is a subgroup on key distribution in that, not yet quantum. So to limit to the quantum technology, we will have to combine the keyword search that we have done before with this specific symbol. And there is actually a dedicated symbol on quantum cryptography. The quantum cryptography symbol 0852 retrieves more or less 2,000 documents, and altogether we get a set of 4,000 documents with this query. So we see now the combinations, the Boolean combinations. So as I said, we combine the keywords and the first more general classification 08, or we take all the documents from the quantum specific quantum cryptography classification. If we do this search, SBuzzNet returns us actually the fields where we have been searching. We have been searching here in the full text mostly. And in the specific classification codes. So you see here CL stands for classification codes, IPC or CPC codes that we are searching for. With this search, we get, as I said, a bit more than 4,000 documents, and we see here the development of the earliest publication date over time. This graph shows us the patent families per year in red, and in gray the patent families cumulative up to the specific year, and we can see that there was a very steep increase of filings into this area. So in 2005 we had around 60 yearly publications in this year, and this increased in 2019 to over 600, and in the cumulative area we have a similar development from over 200 to over 2800. So this technology is getting very important. Secure communication is a key topic these times to make sure that nobody can watch us, can watch the secrets that we are exchanging. AspasNet is pretty good in doing these kind of analysis, but has some limitations with regard to the search query that we can run in AspasNet, because there are limitations with regard to the number of terms that we can query the database against one field. So we can only use query 10 search terms against one specific field, or we can only overall have 20 search terms in our searches. So for analyzing the quantum key distribution area, it is pretty okay to use AspasNet and to find that. But in the report, in the quantum technology and space report, we wanted to analyze in more depth what are the inventions that are actually relevant to space. And for this concept, actually, AspasNet is a bit difficult to use, since we need quite long queries. And we'll see these queries now here in GPI. This is a subscription product that we offer. The first concept is about quantum key distribution. We have seen that already in AspasNet. It's a bit differently worded here. So we have different operators. For example, plus one word means there is a distance between Q and bit one word apart. So there are some other operators possible. And we can also, let's say, extend the search much further and, for example, add the concept 2 of the space relationship. So here we can add now words like satellite or deep space, outer space, spaceborne, spacecraft, and so on, and also some classifications that are specific for space application. Doing that, we can do also some statistical analysis in GPI, for example, looking what are the most prominent CPC classes. And we find that also photonic quantum communication, so the optical elements, are pretty important here. And actually in the report, we did also a dedicated subsection on the optical elements that are used for the transfer of these entangled photons from Earth to the satellite, for example. So overall, when we did the searches, we had already a rough idea what we were searching. So, but what can we do when we want to discover unknown trends? This is a topic I want to analyze in more depth in the second part of this presentation. Unknown trends, yeah, we don't know what we are searching, so we can't have specific keywords for them. We don't have CPC or IPC codes, because CPC or IPC codes are only created when we have a lot of filing in a certain area, so that we create a certain part of the CPC for it so that we can easily retrieve these documents. So the problem here is like that we want to understand unknown patterns. We want to see actually what is in the data that we don't know. That is a bit strange. And I would like to start here with an analogy from nature. So in the following picture, we see here very many green leaves. And the question is, where is the interesting bit in this presentation? Where is the interesting part? And if we look closely and watch what's going on, we may see that something is moving. You have probably seen it in the middle of this picture is a leaf insect, and we have seen it because it was moving. And taking this to patent information, we can detect certain trends if something is changing over time. So we are looking here to now into a different area, traffic control for road vehicle. And this area We analyze it by looking at CPC co-assignments. So you see on both axes of this chart CPC codes, and we look into how often this technology in G08G1 is combined with another technology. Because when we talk to examiners, we know that they say often new inventions are simply new combinations of existing technologies. But if we look into this picture here, there are many bubbles and it's difficult to understand what is important. So in the beginning, we have quite a lot of noise due to classic connection, for example, with data processing for payment, which probably currently doesn't attract too many filings. So it's kind of an old topic. So how can we get this development over time into the picture? Yes, actually, we have added to the PatStat database, a tool with which I have done this study now. We have added the possibility to compare over time these co-assignments, these combinations of various technologies. And what we see here is if we combine the time frame from 2000 to 2016 and from 2016 to 2019, we see that some combinations get less. We see negative development. And these are the red bubbles. And others are getting positive and are getting increasing attention by the filers. So if we're looking into the area of growing combinations, we see that actually this traffic control is more often combined with autonomous vehicles in B60W60 or with automatic pilots based on AI in G085D1-0088. So I saw a promotion where actually you are sitting in an automated vehicle going full speed and you're almost hitting another automated vehicle that is crossing your path. And then the scenery changes. You see the whole scenery from the bird's eye view and you see these two busy traffic streams just intersecting with which is each other and nothing happening. And it's actually mind-blowing. No need for traffic lights in the future if you use such technology. So we see this development also in the patent data. And we see that this automated control with the traffic control system is obviously of more importance. So basically, combinations of CPC codes can help us to identify new things where actually the offices have not yet created a dedicated class for the combinations. Because if these combinations are getting more and more at a certain stage, there will be probably a new CPC that reflects this development. So all in all, I want to sum up. As PatStat and GPI help you to analyze trends that you know already, that you are aware of, and you can look into main applicants, you can look into filing countries, what are the protected markets, and so on. PatStat actually allows you to identify unknown trends by analyzing new combinations of the CPC codes. There is a 1 month free trial for our subscription products, GPI and PatStat, available. So thank you very much for your attention. Try it out and give us your feedback.